Hi everyone. So I'm going to do a second video. You can refer to the first one for the wall with the hallway opening. That's about, I think it was 6 feet. And then this video, I'm going to do the wall with the windows. In class, we already did the wall. So this was the wall with the opening into the hallway or whatever this is, but it's a large opening. So this represents a large opening. Then I also already did the fireplace wall. So that's right here. And that has, this is the doorway. So if we're looking at this fireplace wall, this was for a different floor plan, but today I'm gonna show you the elevation for the window wall. But I'm just showing you what we've already done. And then we also did the elevation already for the wall with the opening here. So this is this opening. So we have three walls already done. So one, two, this is the fireplace one. This is the large one. So that's one, two, and then actually this is the third wall. So what I'm gonna do now is show you how to do the wall with the windows. So I have my floor plan just for reference so that I can click on the items to get my measurements. What you're gonna do is go first into your smart drawer. So if I click onto how you open up your smart drawer, you're gonna go into my documents. Once you're in my documents, you're gonna go to floor plans residential. And then you're going to scroll down to living rooms and then living room elevations. You have to make sure that all of your tools and your walls are elevations or it's not going to come out right. So then you're going to select blank living room elevation. And then what we need to do, so I'm working off of Carissa and Olivia's example that they emailed me. So we need to first do the large wall, which is 16 feet, 5 inches. So this is 16 feet, 5 inches with the two windows. So first we have to adjust our box, which it comes in at 8 feet high, which is fine because typically the height of a ceiling is 8 feet. Some are 9, but average is 8. So you can leave that. Then you'll change this 12 feet that comes in standard. And you'll change that. You can either stretch it out or you can just click and change it to 16 feet, 5 inches. Okay, now to adjust the size of what you're seeing, you just click on this scroll icon down here to make it larger. So now I have my wall. And what I need to do first is put in, we're starting from the back and working our way forward. So we're always working from the, basically the back wall out to the coffee table. Cause when we're doing elevations, it's as if we're standing in the middle of the room, staring at this wall. So I will show you what it will look like from, I believe this one is Carissa's, and then we'll look at Olivia's. Okay. So if I go to my original floor plan, I will get my measurements. So I know that it's 2 feet away and each of my windows are 3 feet. So I'm 2 feet away, then I have a 3 foot window and then 5 feet, 6 inches. So I need to go back to my elevation and then I need to pull out, I like to just pull out a door. And then the door I just use as a guide because there's no measurement tool in the elevation. In the floor plan, you can click measure distance and then you can click and drag to measure any distances. But there is not a tool in the elevation that I see to create those measurements. So we're going to just use a blank box. And we're gonna make it 2 feet. And then you're just gonna shift it over so that it's in line. Again, everything on your elevation is gonna be created from this baseline, meaning everything is gonna sit on this line. So nothing should be floating in the middle, all should be sitting on that line. So then we're gonna pull out windows. So you might have options, you have different windows. So we can pull out a window with the grills, with the window panes. We can pull out just a blank window, a double hung. So for our purpose here, I'm just gonna pull out a traditional standard window. So this will be 3 feet. And then I'll just leave it. I'll make them long windows. So I have them 3 feet by 4 inches. And then what I'm gonna do is move this up because this is actually the guide that I'm using to place my windows. And then just look at your windows in your space. Typically they're about a foot or so down from the ceiling. And then we're gonna copy and paste to get a new marker to measure out our distance of 5 feet, 6 inches. And the 5 feet, 6 inches that I am measuring, I'll show you that in a second. So 5 feet, 6 inches, that is this measurement right here. So from window to window, it's 5 feet, 6 inches. So if I go back to my elevation, I have 5 feet, 6 inches, and then I will copy and paste my window, and then move it over. And then what you wanna do is just double check that your height placement is the same on both, and mine is. So if it wasn't, you would just shift it up or down. All right, so now I can delete all of my guidelines. At this point, I would recommend just grouping this because this is pretty much your wall that you can work with and create different elevations if you needed to. So I would go to design and then say group and then group items. Once I have this grouped, I'm going to be working. I'm actually going to rotate so that I can see the wall that I'm working with. So on this particular wall, we have a bookcase, I believe this is, I'm not 100% sure, but we have a bookcase. And then we have 2 chairs. We have the table in between. We have the sofa. So I'll show you how we're gonna show this. And then we have the coffee table. So we're gonna start working our way from, this might be like a table or a bookcase. So what I'm gonna pull for that is, let's see if there's a side of the bookcase. There's a closet unit. I might just pull out, no, because I don't like that it has the border. If you don't see something that works, then you can just pull out. The rectangle and adjust that. And again, just pull out what, so I'm actually just gonna use, cause it'll be easier, my measure tool. So anytime that it's behind and you can't see it, just bring it to the front right here. And then what you would do is you would go into your floor plan. So I'm just showing the side of this. And this would be my bookcase. So typically, or it's a table, I'm not sure exactly what it is, but whatever it is, you could just show it by a rectangle or whatever it is. If it's a table, pull out the side of a table. So I'll show you if it, we were pulling out a table, what that would look like. So for example, if it was a, maybe it's like a console table, then we could just show it as a console table. Again, go to a site like West Elm or Crate and Barrel and get the height of what you would need to put in. So depending on what this is, I'm not sure, it might be a bookcase. So we'll just put that as a bookcase. All right, then you're gonna take your measurements. So you would go in your floor plan and you would measure over, for example, from the, so we're doing this wall. So I would measure where this bookcase is. So take your measurement to get, and this is 1 foot. So I would measure that. Okay, so back here, now we're gonna put the chairs in. So for the chairs, there's a single sofa chair that you could just pull out and use as an accent chair. You could just adjust it to whatever your size is. So a typical chair is usually like 36 inches wide or so. Some are bigger. Some can be like 33. So just depending on 33 inches, depending on what your chair is. And then you'll copy and paste it. And again, you're gonna actually measure. I'm just eyeballing this because I don't have the actual floor plan access. So I put my two chairs and then I'm gonna grab a, I like to just grab the dining room table actually for the accent tables, because if you make it narrower and make it, again, they're about the same height as the arm. And you would actually measure what the actual table width is. So whatever this is, 20 inches, 24 inches, that's what you would put here. Okay. And you would give a little bit of breathing room. All right, so we would have our two chairs. Now, if we're looking at this, this is way over. So I don't have my measurements, but I can already see that this chair is actually landing probably like a foot over from this window. So I'm actually gonna take everything and I'm going to shift it over. So Chris is gonna have to check her measurements, but it's probably something like this. Okay, so we have our bookcase, we have our windows in the back, we have our two chairs with our table. Then we would have the side of the sofa. So here's the side of the sofa, and then we would need to flip that horizontally. Flip horizontally, it'll flip. And then that would be here. You wouldn't probably see that table behind it, so we won't worry about that. So we would have the side of the table, which it looks like is basically a little bit in front of the window. So it might be like this. And then Carissa has a table on the side. So I would pull out a table, again, adjust the height. And then that would be the side of the table. So we're a little bit further back but from the coffee table, but in this case, I would probably just show it like that. And then we'll add in our coffee table. So we'll pull out a coffee table, and then the coffee table looks like it's in front of the two chairs and the sofa like this. Now, if things start to get too busy, you could also just, if you were highlighting the chairs and the table, you might not show the coffee table, but for the purpose of this, just for you guys to see it, I'm going to show it like this. Now, the other thing is I'm gonna assume that the fireplace is flush against the wall, so I'm not gonna worry about showing anything of the side of the fireplace. If it was a fireplace that stuck out, some of them stick out a foot from the wall, then you could just take the shape and you would just show as if this was the fireplace in front of whatever's behind it. So you would just adjust it to the height. So say this was the fireplace, this is the side of the bookcase or whatever this item is here. And then you have your two windows. Now there aren't any curtains or anything in here. So, you know, you could kind of like fake it, but there really aren't any curtains. But you could put artwork. So if we took one of these and did kind of like a three picture or a large piece of art maybe on this wall just to fill it in or something, you could do something like that. Or you could even put maybe a sconce in the middle of that wall, possibly if you wanted extra lighting. So what that would look like would be, let's see. Oh, the lighting was actually, oh, I didn't add it. Okay, so to add your symbols, you're gonna go to more symbols. You click on those three lines, click more symbols, and then you'll go down to elevations in lighting, And then you'll pull out, you could pull out a wall fixture, a sconce. You could pull out, I'm not gonna pull out a lamp, but I'm gonna pull out a wall sconce. So I'm gonna actually add the library, say okay. And then I'm gonna pull out a wall sconce. And maybe I'll just put a wall sconce in between here, just to give it some, that's like really small. So maybe I'll put the wall sconce over here, like entering in, because that would be, actually it would be hidden by the bookcase. So the point is you could put wall sconces on the wall. This might be a piece of artwork. So that would be this elevation with the windows for this floor plan. If we were then doing the floor plan that Olivia has, if I rotate that, again, I would just group these items. I think I already grouped it, yeah. Okay, so I would copy and paste to show you how to do a second one. And then what I'm gonna do with this one is, I'm not sure what some of these items are, so I think this might be like an ottoman bench. So I'll just pull out the sofa that has no arms or anything, just to get the shape and kind of stick it in the corner. Again, I'm not sure what that is. And you would need to take your measurements. So you're gonna need to go into your floor plan for any items that you have and measure. Okay, so this is 5'4". The distance from the wall is, you have to move it out, okay, 4'4". So anything that you're measuring and placing in the room, you need to see where it's positioned on the floor plan to be accurate. Okay, so going back to our elevation, I have whatever this is. Again, you would have to measure. And it looks like it's more, it's bigger. And if I'm just checking, I just wanna check. This is 2 feet and this is 2'11". Okay, because the one side is bigger. So this side is 2'11", this is 2 feet. That's why it looks different. Okay, so next I'm not sure what this item is here. So I'm going to pretend maybe it's, I don't know. I'll put like a narrow bookcase because I'm not 100%, or it might be a bar. So if I wanted to show a bar, because there's no like bar cart situation, then I would just take out the table and kind of put it in the corner and just make it like a bar cart, pretend, because there's no bar cart. Okay, so that, and then that would be, you just change the height. Then I'm gonna pull out the sofa. So if I'm going to do the sectional, I would have to pull out the face of the sectional first. So that's this area. Don't worry about any curves because you're not gonna be able to show them, but just work with what you have. Again, the point of this is to learn how to do elevations. And then you would need to know the distance between the edge from the wall to the edge of the sofa, or from this wall to the sofa, to know where to place it. So I'm kind of just eyeballing it off of what I'm seeing in the windows. So it looks like it's something like this. And then we would get the side of the sofa and we would flip that horizontally. And that would go right here in front to show that it's a sectional. And then we would just need, I'll pull out the coffee table from there. And then I'll put the coffee table in. Again, everything is all on that line, so nothing is floating. So you wanna make sure that you have 18 inches from your sofa to the coffee table for traffic flow. So that would be 1'6", I believe. Let me just check. Yeah, 1'6". Okay, so that would mean that my coffee table is gonna go over a little bit. which kind of takes it to like the end. And again, you would check the size of this coffee table. So you would go into your floor plan, you would click on whatever your coffee table shape is, and you would get 3 feet, whatever it is, okay? You would click to get your measurements to accurately put them into your floor plan. So now I have my sectional, I have my coffee table. She's got two ottomans in front of the fireplace. So for that, I would probably just pull out, I might just actually pull this again and then just make them narrower because that kind of looks like ottomans. And then now this you would adjust and it looks like they are in line. It looks like they're kind of here, but again, you would measure to see exactly where they are. This is probably more like that. So this is my ottoman. And you would just show the one because you wouldn't see the one behind it. Okay. So now I have my ottoman situation. I have my coffee table with the L shape. I have my, my sofa with the L shape. I have my coffee table, my ottoman, my windows. Again, you can, oh, and then she has a drink table here. So I would probably just show that honestly as a rectangle like this. You could do something like that, or you could, let's say if we take this, oops. This is actually a dining room table. It might not work. Yeah, it doesn't really work. Again, just play around with this, but this is actually a bookshelf, but this might work. So if we took this out and put that to kind of show the C-shaped table. Typically the C-shaped table is going to be, let me just show you a C table. So these are different versions of C tables. So typically they have the two lines and it's clear in the middle. So if I went back to my elevation, I might just do something like make this really narrow. And again, you can zoom in if you need to see this bigger. So I would probably just do something like this for the C table and then copy and paste that. Again, I'm kind of just baking it and you would get your measurements for this. And then you would want to rotate that. Sometimes you have to make it bigger so that you can rotate it. And then make it smaller after. It might be too big. I need to, okay, actually, I don't need to rotate it, I just need to change the shape. I'll make it bigger so you can see. So we don't need to rotate that, we just need to actually adjust the shape of it. So what I would do is something like this. Okay, so that pretty much would show a C table and that would be this wall. So I just wanted to show you guys one more thing about the fireplace wall, which again, if you wanted to add a picture or some kind of, maybe put three pieces of artwork in the middle here or two pieces of artwork, you can get creative and look at some visuals on Pinterest, like maybe you do something like that and that's artwork, or maybe you turn it this the other way and rotate it. Oops. Okay, so we're pretending that's artwork. You would want to center it. Okay, so maybe that's artwork. And that would be how you would draw this wall. So again, we're standing in the center and we're looking straight ahead. Use the doors as the measurement tool. So I just want to show you one more thing on the fireplace wall. So if I went to that elevation, which is here, I'm just gonna copy and paste that over here. I just wanna show you for the fireplace, you're gonna go into symbols and you're actually gonna type fireplace. So when you're in the smart panel and you see it like this with all of your symbols already, you're gonna go to symbols, or you can do search symbols here, which will go there. And then you're gonna type fireplace with no space. If you put a space, it will not come up. So type fireplace, hit enter, and make sure that you take the one that is, these are the floor plan fireplaces, you want the elevation version. So when you pull out this fireplace, you're gonna have to tweak it, because our fireplace, if you look at the floor plan, was 4 feet. So it's 4 feet. Okay. So you're gonna have to, actually it comes in ungrouped. So you'll take this and change it to 4 feet. And it doesn't let you do the measurements. So you're gonna have to take a guideline, change your guideline to 4 feet, like so. So now we have our 4 feet. And then you'll extend everything from this fireplace out. Move your fire over, extend this out. You might want to put a hearth at the bottom of it. So I would just copy and paste this to put a hearth at the bottom, which is one that's raised. Extend that out. And then once you have that done, you'll group this entire shape. So you'll scroll over the whole thing. You'll go to design, group, group objects. And then once you have it grouped, you will go back to your elevation and you'll put it in your elevation. So now how you get that placement is, I'm just gonna ungroup this and delete the one that I already had there. So go to group, ungroup, and then I'll delete this fireplace. How you get this wall is it's 13 feet, 8 inches, and that comes from the floor plan. So that is, let's go on here. So that is right here, 13 feet, 7 inches, Carissa has it, or 13 feet, 8 inches. And then you need to put the opening in. So the opening is actually 2 feet, 6 inches, and you can measure the distance from here to the opening. It's about, it's less than 8 inches, it's like 6 inches over. So we will go back to our elevation, and we will get a marker, send it to the front if you need to. And make that be 6 or 8 inches. I'll just do it 6 inches. Actually, it's 8 inches. And then you'll put your fireplace in. The opening was 2 feet, 6 inches. So again, that you're just gonna grab out from the door and adjust the door to get that shape. So you'll just adjust it to 2 feet, 6 inches. Okay. And then just raise it up to the width. All right, and then this is our marker. So you would go back to your floor plan and it's 5 feet away from the wall to the beginning of the fireplace. So on our elevation, we would mark over 5 feet. And then we put our floor plan, our fireplace in. And that would be how you would do this wall with the fireplace and the opening. And then you would put whatever you have. So in the case of Carissa's, we would have a bookcase. I'll just do this one quick. Or let's see. This case, you would show the back of the fireplace. Now for your assignment, you're doing two wall elevations. So pick the two where you see basically the face of the sofa or like a good view. So if I was doing this one, we would see the side of the chair, the side of the table, the bookcase, and the coffee table. So I would go and grab out a shelf unit that would go, this is too big, that would go here. So we have a shelf unit. And then the fireplace, we'll put the side of the chair in. We'll just put one chair so that we could show the table, and then we'll put the coffee table. So we will go and put a sofa. Oh, actually, we could just use, this is actually a side of the sofa, but we could use it as the chair as well. And then I'm going to flip this. And just get your measurement. So measure from the wall to the back of the chair where it is so that you know where you're placing it. I'm just doing it by eye. So we have our bookcase, we have our chair. I'll put a table in, end table. Actually, I like to show the dining room smaller for the side table. And then there would be another chair. I'm not going to show it, just so that you can see the side of the table. And then I would put the coffee table in. So then that would be here. So then this is the coffee table. And then that would pretty much be your elevation. Up above the TV, you might have, up above the fireplace, you might have a TV. So click search symbols, type in TV. And then there's no flat screen that doesn't have this at the bottom. So what I had done was just flipped it around so that it kind of looked like a TV. So you could put a TV up above the fireplace. You'd want to make it a little bit narrower. You could do something like that, or you could put a mirror. So if we got a mirror, actually, yeah, we'll get this. So we could put a mirror up above. Maybe you want to do it a tall mirror. So that would look like that. You could also put sconces, which is nice. So if we did a mirror and then we put in sconce, which is S-C-O-N-C-E, you'll get wall sconces. So we could take a wall sconce out. You can also get the lighting. I'll show you how to get that. So then, okay, so then we would have our sconces, our mirror, and that pretty much would be this wall. If you need the tools, you would go to smart panel, click on the tools, more symbols, and then you would go to elevations, lighting, and then say okay. And then we have our lighting. So here are more sconces. Here's a different sconce that maybe you want to pull out. So you could do something like that. Okay. So just depending on what you want. And that pretty much would be the fireplace wall and how you would do that. Okay, I'm going to end now.